Welcome to another of our introductory videos relating to practical aspects of temperature metrology. And in this session, we're going to look at the mercury fixed point cell. Got two mercury cells here, a small mercury cell, which like the other cells are good for shorter, smaller thermometers. And then a larger mercury cell, which is better and it's optimized for long stem standard platinum resistance thermometers. So we have the thermometer well, where the thermometer, usually an SPRT, will come into the sealed cell. So the cells are invariably made from stainless steel, and then they have a plastic outer casing, but the stainless steel is the crucible containing the pure mercury. And the mercury is very pure, 7 or 8 nines pure mercury. So to calibrate, we need to realize the mercury triple point. That's at -38.8344°C. So we need to cool these cells, and then we'd normally raise the temperature, and then we've got the mercury triple point to calibrate the thermometer at. These smaller cells, you can use a dry block or a liquid bath to cool them down, ready to use. The larger cells, you can use the same. But we have dedicated apparatus, the mercury triple point apparatus, that makes it very easy to realize the mercury triple point. So mercury in many ways is an ideal fixed point. It's a primary point on the International Temperature Scale of 1990. It's quite easy to realize. We can do that with a very low uncertainty. The temperature is convenient at -38. But the disadvantage is mercury itself is very toxic. Mercury has been replaced in clinical thermometers, for example. And people would really like to find a safer alternative than having to use mercury as a fixed point cell. But that said, until the scientists are able to do some research and introduce a new point, people will require to calibrate SPRTs at the mercury triple point. And the cells themselves are quite safe to use. The mercury is a sealed cell. The mercury is contained inside. There's a vacuum, inside my stainless steel crucible I've got the pure mercury, but all the air's been removed, and it's easy to check if the vacuum's still there. If you listen, you can hear that very distinctive clack. There's no air to cushion the mercury inside, so that gives us confidence that the cell's still to vacuum. So finally, we've been finishing some practical tips about storage of mercury cells. They're quite easy to store. We store ours vertically, normally leave it in the apparatus or we keep it in a secure cupboard. They're not so fragile, compared to some of the other cells. So if you need to transport a mercury cell, you don't need to worry too much about the transport of it, other than because mercury itself is classified as hazardous. Special regulations apply because you're shipping a hazardous substance. In terms of safety of the cell, it's fairly assured. So finally, thank you very much for watching this very brief introduction to the mercury fixed point cell. If you'd like further information about the ITS-90, about mercury fixed point cells, then be sure to visit the ICETEC website. And finally, be sure to subscribe to be kept up to date with new videos from ISOTEC.